Hello dear students, in this video of States of Matter, we are going to discuss about an important phenomena, that is diffusion. Now, before explaining what is diffusion, let us discuss some examples in our day-to-day life where we experience this phenomena. Suppose someone in your house sprays a perfume in one of the rooms. You still can smell the fragrance of the perfume sitting in other end of the house. Similarly, when your mom is cooking some food in the kitchen, you will be able to get the smell of the food sitting in another room in your house. How smell of a thing reaches from kitchen to your room, or fragrance of the perfume reaches from one room to another, it depends on this phenomena known as diffusion. To explain diffusion, we will first discuss the definition of diffusion. It says movement of particles from region of higher concentration to region of lower concentration. Now, region of higher concentration means a region where the molecules are greater in number. From there, they move to the other end where they are lower in numbers. For that, we will explain a diagram which is drawn over here. Let us consider a container which is having water and it is dipped with a red colored solid in the first diagram. Now you can see the red color solid is initially at the bottom. Suppose after 15 minutes, I observe this container. What I see is that the red color is sprayed throughout the liquid now. Why this happens? Initially, this red colored solid is at the bottom of the container. So the concentration of red particles was more at the bottom. As this red colored solid is soluble in water, the particles will diffuse throughout the water and they reach from bottom to top, that is region of high concentration to the region of low concentration. How this red color spreads throughout the liquid? For that, we have to understand the collision theory of the particles. Red colored particles, as they dissolve, they collide with neighboring water particles. As they collide on each other, the particles bounce off and move randomly throughout the liquid. As they move randomly throughout the liquid, red color spreads throughout the liquid. This random and rapid movement of particles is known as Brownian motion. So what is Brownian motion? It is defined as a motion of particles which is random and rapid. We can explain same phenomena for the perfume particles as well. When someone sprays the perfume, these perfume particles collide with neighboring air particles in the room. As they collide with the air particles, they bounce off and they spread randomly throughout your house. And hence, a person, if he sprays perfume in one room, the fragrance reaches to other room as well. This is known as diffusion. Now, not all particles diffuse at the same rate. Some particles diffuse faster, that is, they move at faster speed from one end to other, whereas some particles diffuse at much slower rate. Now, it depends on two important factors, that is molecular mass and temperature. First, talking about molecular mass, a heavier particle will take time to move from one end to other end, whereas a lighter particle will be able to move at faster rate from one end to other. That makes me understand rate of diffusion is inversely proportional to molecular mass. Heavier particle will diffuse slower, whereas a lighter particle will diffuse faster. To explain that, we will take another example here, wherein we have taken NH3, that is ammonia, and HCl. Now, ammonia has molecular mass 17, whereas HCl has molecular mass 36.5. Simply speaking, HCl is heavier than ammonia. So, in unit time, HCl will move lesser distance compared to ammonia, as ammonia is lighter. So, if I take two cottons, one soaked in HCl and another soaked in NH3, we would understand that HCl will cover less distance in given time, whereas ammonia will cover longer distance. If both of them would diffuse at same rate, they would meet each other somewhere at the center of the tube. But as their rates of diffusion are different, they would not meet at the center, but they will meet towards HCl, as HCl covers less distance than ammonia. You can understand from the diagram that ammonia has covered this much distance, whereas HCl has covered distance from here to here. Now, how do we understand that they are meeting over here? It is simple that HCl and ammonia, when they react together, they form dense white fumes of ammonium chloride, that is NH4Cl. We would see these dense white fumes somewhere here, that is nearby HCl, proving that HCl diffuses slower than ammonia. The second factor that affects the rate of diffusion is temperature. As we discussed in our previous videos, that at high temperature, molecules gain kinetic energy. So, at high temperature, they will have greater kinetic energy, and so their rate of diffusion would also be greater. So, if I consider same test tube and I heat it from the center, would you think that this spot where we are getting NH4Cl would be any different? The answer is no. We would get the spot at the same position, but the change will be this spot would be observed at much earlier time compared to our first experiment. Reason: when we heat the test tube from outside, the effect of temperature would be similar for HCl as well as for NH3, as they will be sharing the heat energy provided. But if I take out HCl and heat it separately before putting it into the tube, then I would see this spot at some different position, as HCl being heated, it will diffuse at faster rate. So, temperature is directly proportional to the rate of diffusion. In this video, we understood an important concept, diffusion, that is movement of particles from region of higher concentration to lower concentration, wherein particles collide, bounce off, and move randomly. Please remember these keywords, as you will require them while answering questions related to diffusion. The factors affecting diffusion, that is molecular mass and temperature. Rate of diffusion is inversely proportional to molecular mass, whereas rate of diffusion is directly proportional to the temperature. Thank you.